The other factor that I wanted to tell you is, how emotionally dependent are you on others compared to being emotionally dependent on yourself? See, in practical areas you can be dependent. A wife may choose to be a homemaker and therefore financially dependent on her husband. I don't earn a single rupee. Whatever we run our household and our family based on that, I'm dependent on him financially. Absolutely nothing wrong with that thing. A child may be dependent on an elder. I can't cross the road alone, or I can't handle money, go and buy something. So even though grandfather has given me money to buy a present, I am requesting uncle or cousin, please come with me to the shop, help me to buy that. So financially, security wise, money wise, so many other areas, it's perfectly okay to have dependency, and better than that to have interdependency. Rather than being only dependent, if you are interdependent, then, like I gave the example, the wife takes the responsibility of the home and says, don't worry, children will be looked after, house will be clean, good food will be cooked, everything. You leave that to me, you go and work. And the husband says, okay, as long as you are taking care of this, don't worry about the finances, I will make sure that every month the money comes in, so you won't have to scrounge or you won't have to starve. So that way there is interdependence. But when it comes to emotions, you have to learn to be dependent on yourself. The more you are emotionally dependent on somebody else, one of the remarks which I often make, which people get very angry with me, is when somebody says, I love him so much, I cannot live without him. Sounds very loving and very warm and whatever it is, isn't it? But what do you mean when you say, I love him so much that I cannot live without him? I think the only thing I cannot live without is oxygen. So, is my loved one my oxygen cylinder? And just think of the impact on the other person when I appoint him as my official oxygen cylinder. How uncomfortable it makes the other person. If something goes wrong with the ball, this person is going to die. So I have to make sure that I keep giving the oxygen 24/7. Now that is not love, that is dependency. That is emotional dependence. If you say, I love this person so much that he or she enriches my life. My life is complete by itself. I will live another 100 years whether this person exists in my life or not. But the quality of life improves because I love him so much and he or she is so nice to me and we have shared such a wonderful equation or whatever it may be. Then it is fine. So one way of taking care of yourself, being nice to yourself, loving yourself, is to ensure that you are emotionally dependent only on yourself and nobody else in this whole world.